Please give it up for Gujarat's very own Parthiv Patel. How are you doing, Parthiv? Parthiv, I have a mic for you that's coming right now. There is the mic, and so good to see Parthiv. I can't even have a chat till I get the mic. Jaldi aa jao mere bhai. Aa rahe sir. Kya baat hai? Thank you, sir. On the hot seat. How are you doing, Parthiv?
Very good. Just a quick correction. I'm no more Mumbai Indians. I'm with RCB now.
सर शुरुआत तो की थी सर सर आप क्यों खुश हो रहे हैं ही इज जॉइन आरसीबी इट्स सो गुड बट देन यू एक्चुअली आई मीन माय फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज स्टार्टिंग अ करियर एट 17 उस टाइम तो बच्चों के भी इट्स नॉट बच्चों बट उस टाइम जनरली यू हैव अ लॉट ऑफ बटरफ्लाइज बट यू वेंट ऑन विद ऑल द बिग नेम्स इन द इंडियन क्रिकेट टीम व्हाट वाज द फीलिंग
सी ऑनेस्टली व्हेन यू आर 17 सी When you start playing cricket at the junior level, your only goal is to, you know, play for India and represent your country. So when I got selected, I felt, you know, the one goal is done. Now I have to go and play. So my test debut actually happened accidentally. So Ajay Ratra was the first keeper, mm-hmm. and he was taking throwdowns and he got injured on a. Like 5 minutes before the toss, and I was actually giving throwdowns to someone else. So after the toss, I came to know that I'm going to play the test match because I was throwing down to someone else. But yeah, at 17, there are no expectations. You just go out there and have fun. I remember going into the dressing room, you know, having seen Sachin Tendulkar, Saurav Ganguly, Rahul Dravid at the Bangalore NCA just before going to Under-19 World Cup. You know, and it was just 5 months before I made my test debut. So I had picked a day in a dressing room where, you know, I will just look at Sachin Tendulkar today in a dressing room. What does he do? How does he prepare? So the next day was for Rahul Dravid and all. So it was for the first few days, it was like for me, it was, you know, where am
I? Were you intimidated or what was on the mind? You know, there's a fan moment. You basically look up to these guys and you get inspired.
See, obviously, you know, they are the inspiration. They are the reason why a lot of us have started playing cricket. Sachin Tendulkar was the reason for me and for a lot of us in our generation. We started playing cricket because we all wanted to become Sachin. We all want to become Tendulkar. And yeah, first, I didn't know how will I address them. Whether I'll say Sachin sir, I'll say Sachin bhai, or what will I say? I had no idea. But once you get into the dressing room, the kind of big stars they are. They actually are not when you get in your dressing room. They actually make you feel like, you know, like home, where they know, they understand the pressure of, you know, what happens when you are representing country. So they try and make you as comfortable as possible.
And generally, what I've heard is I speak with a lot of these guys. There's a lot of appreciation, encouragement. Ke saath saath khichai bhi hoti thi. Aapki ragging hui thi?
नहीं एक्चुअली उनको लगा कि मैं बहुत छोटा हूँ इसलिए रैगिंग करने का फ़ायदा है नहीं आई टेल यू एन इंसिडेंट द नेटवेस्ट फाइनल द फेमस फाइनल वेयर सौरव टुक ऑफ हिज शर्ट सो द वन डे टीम वाज ऑलरेडी देयर दे वर प्रैक्टिसिंग सो मी वसीम जाफर संजय बांगर एंड शिव सुंदर दास वी फोर वेंट फॉर द प्रैक्टिस इन अ कैजुअल ड्रेस सो देर वर फ्यू प्लेयर्स हु हैड नॉट सीन मी बिफोर दैट दे नो पार्थिव पटेल बट दे डिडंट नो how I look. So me and Wasim just entered the ground, the practice arena at the Lords. And Anil Kumble actually asked Wasim, "Tere bhai ka ladka hai saath mein karke." So there were a few stories, but I've never got dragged.
No, that was. I mean, imagine what must have gone through your mind saying, "No, yaar, ye itna underestimate kar rahe hain types." You know.
No, I mean, and then Rahul Dravid was there, and so he had seen me, so he's like, he's Parthiv, so acha, oh, theek hai. But then, you know, you just look at Anil Kumble and there are no thoughts, you know.
But honestly, I mean, just look at you playing alongside a lot of big names. Imagine we've got like Cheche Foot ke players, hote hain, Matthew Aiden, or you have bowlers. Which is the bowler which actually intimidated you? Because there's a lot of, aap intimidate karte samne wale ko, you start saying things and stuff. Were you at any point in time in the beginning of your career face this?
See, honestly, not really. I mean, I've loved fast bowling. You know, I've always liked the ball coming onto the bat. I've always felt the faster it comes, the faster it goes from the bat. And having been grown up in Ahmedabad, where, you know, turf wicket was not there until 2000, so we've grown up on our matting wickets, where, you know, ball would come slightly faster than the normal turf wicket would. So I've always enjoyed it. I used to get scared by slower bowlers, because I felt, you know, Michael Vaughan, you know, he was probably the bowler which I felt that he would get me out in first test match, not the Harmison, not the Flintoff, or not anyone else.
So what has been the journey like, starting off in 2002 to now? It must be a lot of ups and downs. I've seen the down as well. What was the inspiration of you bouncing back? Who's been behind you, and what's been the thought process?
See, I think I've played, I was dropped when I was 19 and a half. You know, I mean, then I thought, at that point of time, I thought I will never be able to catch the ball again, or I will never be able to play, hit the boundary ever, because every time there were a lot of self-doubts, because, you know, I had never seen the downside, because it was till then everything was up. So for me, it was very difficult to handle around that period. Rob, every time I went on to play a club cricket game, I thought there were 11 fielders on the offside and 11 on the leg side. I don't think, I could not see the gap. Or if someone would throw a tennis ball at me, I used to get scared for a year. So then I went back to my basic things. I try and learn everything from scratch. You know, I would just do a front foot defense for like 500 balls. Though I was 20, I had played test cricket. I started playing matches with under 16 boys, just to get the confidence back, just to get that feeling of scoring hundreds again, just to get that feeling of catching the balls again. So I'd actually practiced with under 16 boys for a year, just to feel that, you know, I can play cricket again. And then for 2-3 years, when you're not performing, when you're not doing well even at the domestic level, I'd actually spoken to Anshuman Gaikwad, who was our Gujarat coach, and I told him, I think I need to get back to the studies now. You know, I've not completed my school. I need to, you know, think of an alternative career. So I don't think I can play cricket ever again. I remember a game against Railways where we were playing at Motera, where first ball I defended, I got nicked and keeper dropped it. He dropped, I went to same other end, that was last ball. Then another off spinner came in, I nicked it again, the slip fielder dropped it. Then I came to another end and then got out. So in three balls, actually I got out thrice. And that was a time where I decided I will just chuck it, I won't play cricket again. But then went back, did a lot of basic things, did a lot of, yoga and a lot of training in terms of, you know, how I want to, you know, get back to the cricket. The family plays a huge role in your in everyone's career. You know, I think they realize that, you know, I've been down and almost out, so they've helped me a lot. I think the local association here, you know, I've requested a lot of things to them to play with under 16 boys, under 19 boys. They've helped me out throughout the career so far. And after 3 years, for 2 years I did not play cricket, and Dilip Vengsarkar, who was the chairman of selectors then, and he was the one who had picked me as under 19 India captain. So I called him, sir, I've started playing cricket again. So he directly picked me for India A tour, for India A and Zimbabwe. And there I scored 500s in 5 innings, and I'm the only first class player in the history of Indian cricket to do that, to score 5 first class 100s. So from then it took off. Then obviously IPL, where you play against a lot of great players. So yeah, and for me, I think the biggest highlight of my career is winning a Ranji Trophy for Gujarat.
Absolutely, tell us about that. You know, this is incredible. I have to tell you this. Ranji Trophy, jahan par bade bade diggaj khelte hain. You've got states really vying for it. Parthiv got that to Gujarat, and that's incredible. Tell us about that.
See, there was, as I said, you know, when I got back on the track, Mahendra Singh Dhoni was the captain of the side. So there was no chance for me to, play for India again unless he gets injured. So my aim was to improve my game. And in the practice, I had made a goal. I'd promised myself that, you know, I will play more balls than a junior most player does. So if a junior most player has played 100 balls, I will play 120. And if a junior most player has taken 120 catches, I will take 150. So by doing that, I will improve myself and the team will get improved as well. Because I think when you work hard, sooner or later, you do get your results. You know, and the other aim was to win Ranji Trophy for Gujarat. And I know it was a long process, but I could believe that because we had team. We had good young players who could do it, but it was just a matter of making sure that belief, everyone, each one of us at the GCA and the players, everyone believes that we can win it.
Absolutely. Fantastic. Let's give a big round of applause for that. Now, I've got the final two questions, real hard-hitting ones. First up, how did Parthiv Patel, the cricketer, turn into a businessman? How has cricket evolved? Like when you started in 2002, there were not too many managers who used to manage players. So in brief, tell us how it's changed and how the business element has come into cricket.
There's a huge change. I think there were only two companies before in 2002 who used to manage players, and they used to give minimum guarantee. So they would give certain amount. That has gone out of the window now. And the biggest change was if you are a manager and you're managing me, you get the money directly from the brand and you get your percentage and then you pay me. Now it has changed that, you know, I get the money directly and I pay the manager. For some reasons, there have been a lot of ups and downs in the player and management kind of a thing. So that has changed. There are a lot of players who've got into the business kind of a thing. I was just briefly, I'll tell what we've developed a product for a bat swing with Intel, developed a product where you can see your bat swing, you can see how you've been hitting the ball. So hopefully it should be out by IPL.
Incredible, there you are. And fine, let's give a round of applause. That's, you know, growing from one end to the other. Finally, dressing room secrets before you leave. Who's the biggest prank in the Indian team?
There are a lot of them, I think. You know, I mean, we are completely different what we see on the field and what we are in the dressing room. Nowadays, there's a, you know, the fitness thing is so big that everyone, you know, likes to show off their six packs. So, you know, whoever has their six packs, they walk around.
So do you have six packs?
It's a process. So whoever has their six packs, they would walk without the t-shirt, and whoever doesn't have it, they try and, you know, get the tummy inside and try and do it. But yeah, I mean, Hardik is very, Virat is with someone who keeps their dressing room alive.
And there you are, we're getting like a little secrets. Before we let Parthiv go, who's the most romantic cricketer we have?
See, I think they're all the guys in the dressing rooms and whatever.
Everyone's romantic.
I hope not. No, but yeah, I mean, see.
The reason I'm asking you is, IPL mein you have a lot of distractions. Ek chauka mara, it goes there, and then you've got like, first the cheerleaders cheering for you, then cheerleader ke piche koi cheer kar raha hai. And so, you know, the other day when I was speaking with Virat, Virat was telling, you know, main bola, yaar, beech mein aap baat kya karte ho? So he was in a very joking mood. He said, yaar, wahan pe na, wo bahut khubsurat lag rahi hai.
No, actually, sometimes we do that. Just, you know, yeah, I mean, we just talk something which is not cricket. You know, because we want the subconscious to take over. So we talk something else. You know, we sledge, we talk whatever we want to talk about. Yeah, obviously, when you're 25, 30, or whatever age you are, you first thing, first thing that comes into your mind is the girl factor, the women.
We just celebrated Women's Day.
Yeah, we did yesterday. Didn't
Cricketers
we?
Celebrate it every day.
Well, see, I'm married for 10 years now, so I don't have that luxury now.
But ladies and gentlemen, Parthiv Patel, let's give him a big round of applause. But before that, he is celebrating his birthday and anniversary today. You got married on your anniversary, or rather on your birthday. So what we're going to do is, everybody's going to join me in wishing Parthiv. Let's do a happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Parthiv. Happy birthday to you. And ladies and gentlemen, gifts are accepted. So each one of you can, I'll take it on your behalf and I'll deliver you. But we have a token of appreciation. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from the TIE Governing Council member. Please give it up for Ms. Neha Sheth, who's going to come on the stage for the token appreciation. Let's give a big round of applause. Parthiv Patel.